Hello, Sterla here. Welcome to another tips video for Web, a no-code web builder for visually building and launching premium content. Here at Web, we believe in every digital experience is about interaction at its core. With this in mind, we have launched a native interactions tool in Web where you can decide how your design should interact with audience down to the smallest details. Interactions in Web revolve around three key terms: trigger, target, and action. Think of trigger as the starting point, like clicking a button, target as the area where something will happen, like an image, and action as what actually happens, such as an image being shown. You can add interactions in two ways, from the Interactions tab or directly from the canvas. First, select your component, click Interactions in the top right. Next, select your target and set the action, such as show, hide, and so on. Alternatively, you can hover over a component in the canvas until you see the plus button, drag to your target, set your trigger, and choose action. Now that you got the basics down, let's put them into practice by creating an interactive menu component. First off, let's make a simple landing page. Start by adding a menu icon. Then add a text box and style it however you want it. You can now duplicate the text box and change the text and styling. When you have added your menu items, you can select them all and add them into auto layout. Set the auto layout frame to be 50% width and 100% height, and then right align it. You may want to change your background color so it's easier to work with. Next, add an image with 50% width and 100% height, and then left align it. Group the image and the auto layout frame, and then name the new frame menu. Also, remember to name all your layers properly. Now, hide the menu and add a frame that covers the whole page. Set the opacity to be 0% and then add a background blur effect to it. Go ahead and hide this layer too. If you want a more fancy menu, you can go ahead and add animations to all the different layers within the menu frame and also to the menu frame itself. You decide. Finally, it's time for some interactions. Duplicate the open menu icon and then change the icon to a close menu button. Rename it and then drag it into the menu frame from the layers panel. Now, select the open menu icon and then go to interactions and choose on click. The target is the menu and the action is show. The second interaction should be hide the open menu icon. The third one is show the close menu icon. And the fourth will be show for the blurred layer. Then select the close menu icon. This time we want the menu to close, so we choose on click and select the menu as the target and the action to be hide. We also need the open icon to reappear when the menu is closed, so select it as a target and then choose show. Finally, select the blurred layer as a target and set it to hide. And there you have it, a functional menu. We listed a public link for this project in the description below, so feel free to copy-paste them into your project for your own exploration. For more information on interactions, please visit the documentation link below or visit our community to ask any questions you may have. Now, head to Web to try it out yourself.